What's going on, everybody? C4 here. Welcome back to the channel. And today we're here for episode 4 of our Madden 21 Philadelphia Eagles series, week 13 against the Green Bay Packers. Now, this should be coming to you guys live before the Eagles Monday night game against Seattle Seahawks, which you guys saw here in the Power of Madden, where we got absolutely worked. 51-27 by Russell Wilson, DK Metcalf, and just everything else. How Carlos Hyde had one hell of a game against us. So hopefully we could turn that around here. Week 13 against Aaron Rodgers, Davante Adams, and the Green Bay Packers. Last time Philly played Green Bay, Jordan Howard had like 3 touchdowns. He was unstoppable. And Philly kind of handled business. I think that game ended also with an interception. Craig James picked off Aaron Rodgers in the red zone. It was a great victory. So hopefully we can have that correlate in real life. And also, hopefully, this kind of inverse of the Madden results to real life results continues, where we are 2-0. In Madden, and the Eagles in those same games in real life went 0-2. We finally had our first loss of this series against Seattle. Pretty bad loss. So hopefully that means in real life, Philadelphia is going to shock the world, get a massive upset, and reclaim first place in the NFC least. I may look a little bit different when I come back. I'm not freaking out, but to add some real life to this video, I am about to go get my first COVID test. Which is my first one. I live in a place that's very fortunate. We pretty much went like the whole summer without any COVID cases. It kind of blew up a little bit when everyone was coming back, because we're like, where I live, it's pretty much like a university college town. So everyone coming back from different parts of Canada, different parts of the world, kind of a little bit of a spike. But it was like when, you know, basically 2 weeks ago, literally 14 days to this point, I went to a restaurant regretfully. I did not want to go there. I got dragged there. It was one of those things like, oh, I'm hanging with my buddies. And they're like, hey, let's go to a restaurant. And I wasn't going to be like, turn the car around, I'm going home. I was like, whatever, we don't have any cases. And of course, I made a tweet about it. The Jalen Hurts second round pick of COVID luck. The place that I went to did have contact tracing. I have to get tested. I probably don't need to. I'm symptom free. I've had a little bit of a runny nose, but it's 14 days. I've had no fever, no cough, but I'm doing my part. Because if everyone, at least where I live in Canada, if everyone kind of says, oh, I'm fine, it doesn't get tested, the whole system doesn't work. My kid and my girlfriend got tested this morning. They have head colds right now. So we're just kind of being proactive about everything. So hopefully, you know, in a day or so, I have really good news. I could say that I'm COVID-free, and, you know, because I've been doing my job. I'm doing my part. I'm wearing my mask. I've been proactive, you know, all that stuff. And it sucks. Like, I'm more so worried that I'm like going to have to stand in line with people that are sick, and those germs are going to be around me. But I don't know. Hopefully I'm good, and hopefully when I come back in about an hour's time, you're not going to see it, I'm going to edit it, we will be COVID-free, and, well, I won't know, but the test will know, and I'll be able to use that power, use that energy within the universe to destroy and dismantle everything that the Green Bay Packers are working for. Like, looking at this matchup here, big advantage for us is I don't respect their wide receivers outside of Davante Adams. I think we're going to have a great stop there. I don't think they're going to be able to run the ball against us with, you know, Aaron Jones, big fan of the channel, my adopted son. While if he does have a big game, I'll be proud of him, but I think that's what we're going to stop, and it's just going to be Aaron Rodgers probably going for 90% completion percentage, but we need to be able to do the same against the Packers defense. We're coming off of week 12 where Avante Maddox, 9 tackles and a pick 6.
Mine.
Oh! Give me a little bit! Yes! Avante Maddox has earned it. He's been very good today. Thank God we could get one back. Gets NFC Defensive Player of the Week. Pretty good. I absolutely hate how good Cam Newton is in the sim. Because we started with real stats. Cam's been pretty bad. Let's be honest. Cam's been actually dog shit. And yet in the Madden sim, he is unstoppable. He is godlike. And they tried to do everything possible to make him into, you know, MVP Cam Newton. As you can see here in the sim, he had 5 touchdowns. Super annoying. We have a breakout scenario from Travis Fulgham. Yes, sir. Already got him to go up from a star dev. Here we go. If we can get him 3 touchdowns or 150 yards, we will have a now superstar wide receiver on the Philadelphia Eagles. I can't remember the last time Philadelphia had a superstar caliber wide receiver. I don't think since they've had those dev traits, we've had one. I don't think Alshon had it. Really, outside of Zach Ertz, we haven't had anybody above a star dev for sure. So that'd be kind of special, right? To get Travis Fulgham, Fulgham season, even though in real life he's kind of fizzling out just a little bit. But in the life of Madden, let's continue to have him go off and dominate. We have some upgrades here. Some of our players, Malik Jackson, I don't think he's really going to be in our long-term plans. Most likely he will be a free agent and bouncing. Jalen Mills, we'll continue to work on him as a scheme fit. Actually, like, this series here, like when I, like this is, you know, kind of first thing in the morning for me. I actually am doing like the training, like the drills and stuff like that, just to kind of get me loose, get me back into Madden. It's been a couple days since I've played. And like, you actually get some good XP in that. But we'll just spend the points here. Alshon Jeffrey, another guy, much like Malik Jackson. Is he going to be on our roster to start things off next season? I don't know, but we might as well maximize the talent while he is a member of the Philadelphia Eagles. So 5-5-1 Philly against the 9-2 Green Bay Packers, looking to bounce back. What are the injury report looks like? What is the Packers handicap? Because we sure as shit know, Philadelphia, we still don't have Zach Ertz. Brandon Brooks done for the year. Still don't have DeSean Jackson. And then everyone else is gone. Looking at Green Bay. The center's gone. That's a decent loss. Lazard, nice weapon for them. Funchess. Nothing too serious, though. Definitely more healthy than we are. More poised for a playoff run than we are. But that's fine. Because when our back's against the wall, that is where Coach Doug Peterson gets his guys playing the best football. Week 13, Green Bay. Let's get it. I'm back, baby. COVID can't hold me down. Shout out to the fact that it's yet again another snow game where I'm wearing a white uniform and my old man eyes are probably going to struggle here a little bit. Terrible kickoff, giving Aaron Rodgers starting field position on his own 39. Okay. Get up! Yes, Fletcher Cox finally, getting pressure, finally able to get home once we blow up a guard. He's blown up guards all season long, hasn't been able to seal the deal, gets his fifth sack of the season, and we provide a little bit of resistance here. Now it's 3rd and 14. We'll go, put a little man defense out there. Trust our guys. I really probably should go in the settings here and make sure Darius Slay follows Davante Adams, as that's the only guy. The rookie out of Clemson, Kayvon Wallace, gets back-to-back sacks. That is a huge response from this Eagles defense after giving up 42 yards from Rodgers to Tonyan on the first play of the game. Terrible opening field position with a bad special teams kick. And with that, it's going to be a long field goal here. What are we talking about? That's like, what, 50? Somewhere in that range, maybe even a little bit longer. Mason Crosby got a leg on him. Let's see. It's up. And he shanks it! A win for the Philadelphia Eagles defense. Now, here's hoping on offense with the white jerseys in the snow that, you know, I can find a way to endure and suffer and find a way to win. They started with a big pass. Figure we might as well start with a big pass. Richard Rodgers, old Dick Rod, going against his former team. Could he have a huge game in store? And he does! Just like that, they got four. We didn't get as much, but 24 yards. Richard Rodgers. He definitely wants to have a big game here today. Same thing. Keeping on the ground. It's worked so far. Miles Sanders able to get the first down and a lot more. If there is a weakness of this Green Bay Packer defense, I would guess it's going to be picking on the linebackers and running the ball against them. There we go. Follow your blockers. Another first down. Now, I do need to get Fulham involved. We have a superstar dev trade on the line. I'm more so thinking maybe we just get him touchdowns. What was it, 3 touchdowns? That's doable. Just to try to go to him to cap off the opening drives or get insta-sacked by Za'Darius Smith. 3rd and 9. That scrambles with his feet. Looking for it. Looking for Alshon to break off there. Absolutely nothing. Eats the sack. That's better than a turnover because at least we're still in field goal range to get some points. 49-yarder. Makeable. See, he went 7 win. It's makeable for Jake Dale. He got a good leg. What? Man, I'm telling you right now, there's something wrong with my controller. There is a lag, an input lag, that I don't know why. I don't know why. Maybe I need to make the transition to this Madden 21 controller. Because this is, I don't know, man. That is all my controller. And it's been like that in the menus. I thought that was just a menu thing. Now the fact that it's carrying over to gameplay, we might have to RIP to the red velvet cupcake controller here. Not good enough. Like, look, I did X twice just to call that play. Yeah, there's some, I'm going to fix this. I'm not sabotaging my game just to, we're going to go with the Madden controller. Okay, well, what happened on this play? Wow. Actually, doesn't feel like there's a first time using this. Thanks to EA for the Madden controller. Let's get a good look at that there. Look at that. So, connect to the controller. However, because when I start the game, when you start the game in Madden, you can't have access to your mouse, like your PC mouse. You're locked into the controller. So I couldn't hit the record button. So I pretty much was at mercy of one play. And of course, that one play was this. They just hit Davante Adams. He broke a tackle and went all the way. I could not record it. Oh yeah, this controller. Oh, got that brand new controller smell. It has like, feels amazing. I'm gonna win now because I'm using the Madden controller. Look at that. First down. Miles Sanders moved the chains. Got it right in the middle. Oh. That's a tough grab. And Siu Malu, our starting left guard. Apparent injury. That means, I don't even know who would be in there. Herbig, maybe? Nate Herbig or Jack Driscoll, one of the two. A lot of pressure. Through shoulder. Yeah, let's keep him in there. Honestly, if he goes down, it is what it is. But I'm going to ride him till the wheels fall off.
Take us out, tablet.
Third and 10. Oh, my God. Make the jump. Oh, he gets popped. No PI. No PI on that. Punt it. That was close. Turnover. That would have been another pick six in back-to-back weeks for Davante Maddox. But the pressure is getting there. It's getting Aaron Rodgers. Third and 4. Same thing. They're probably going to hit the double team. Instant pass, Darius Slay able to limit the game, but Rodgers is good, man. We can't let him get in a rhythm. A little bit of a blitz. We just sit back. Aaron Rodgers is going to pick on us. You know, you're not going to blitz every time. Oh, that needs to not happen. That needs to not be a completion. Third and 10. This is where Jim Schwartz's old defense needs to stand up here. Third and 10, third and long on their side. So this is punt territory if we can get a stop.
Mine.
And it's big play Slay. They try to go to MVS. Darius Slay gets his first interception, I think, as a member of the Philadelphia Eagles. His 20th pick on the year. Aaron Rodgers has been getting a little bit loose with that football. There was a pass a couple plays ago that could have been picked. And Darius Slay punishes, gives good starting field position for Philadelphia. Oh, Miles. Yeah, the run. We're going to have to stick with the run game. We might have to throw out the dev trade for Fulham. The win is more important right now for the team. We already got him go up one. Maybe we'll get a... Don't want to be too greedy. But I do think I will try and keep a balance to my offense and then maybe force feed him in the red zone, try to get it via touchdowns. Oh, that is a terrific pass down. Probably could have hit that in stride, but... We don't want to, you know, we're not greedy. We're not a greedy offense here in Philadelphia. I'm going to make sure with the safe catch that I get those yards. It's not a drop. It's a snow game. You never know. Bad drops can happen. Second and 7 on the 14. Fulham might be nice. Depends what Jair Alexander does. Nope, throw it away. I'm not going to pick on Jair. As much as I like Fulham, that is not a good matchup whatsoever. I move Fulham into the slot to maybe give us a better chance here at hitting some plays. We'll go slants, see if that's open. If not, honestly, I just want some points. We gotta get something off that interception.
Fuck!
Go. Nice TFL Singleton. Guy, I think, honestly, earned his spot in the team next year. I don't think I'm going to try to draft his replacement in this upcoming draft or sign someone to take over him in free agency. I think Singleton, he's going to be first name on the sheet for our linebackers next year. Able to force the punt. Couple drops there. Fourth and 5. Let's see if we can get good field position. Again, it's just, fuck, man. We didn't have that interception. Didn't have the input lag on the field goal. you know, we'd be looking at good right now. We'd be maybe winning. Line, which kind of does. Gets a little bit of a step. Kind of fit it between the linebackers there. Goddard making plays, moves the chains. Oh, shit. Go. Yeah, we're in scoring range. I will 100%, just if the pass does not look good, I'll throw it away and even eat like a grounding penalty. I'm getting points this drop. Especially with how our defense is playing, it's not necessarily going to have to be match Aaron Rodgers touchdown for touchdown here. I think they're keeping us in it. Don't know why that just happened. How do I get out of this? How the hell do I get out of this menu? Replay. Nope. Not what I want. There we go. Close it. Snap the ball.
Stupid.
Might as well play like this for the rest of the game. There you go. Oh, no. Maybe Darius Slay can catch him. It's Tanyan. Yeah. We're not winning. Hey, you guys can probably, if you're really, really interested in the win-loss of this game, probably just skip ahead about 10 minutes. We're going to fucking lose. I think like when I got my COVID test, they tickled a part of my brain that's just playing smart and Madden. It's gone. They flicked the switch inside there or something. Or I'm like Cam Newton. Remember Cam Newton looked real good with the Patriots, tested positive for COVID. Now he's averaging like 87 passing yards a game. Something like that is probably what I'm going through here. But a nice defensive stand, 3rd and 5. Would certainly go a long way. Fletch. Let's go, Fletch. He blows it up. Duke Riley's terrible. Definitely does not belong being a starter, but he's the best we have. 1st and goal, Packers. Great run, treat. Go, Miles Sanders, just like that. Couple runs, we're into Packer territory. 3rd and 10, we got a gas Miles Sanders. I'm not throwing the ball. So, maybe I'll throw it on 4th down. What do we got here? 4th and 11 on the 44. We screen pass to him? No chance. Turnover on downs. 3rd turnover of the game. Awesome.
Good. Great. Grand. Wonderful.
Oh, my God. See, that's the worst. That honestly, maybe more than the fact that, like, quarterbacks on All Madden have an unrealistic completion percentage. Like, I wasn't using Kevon Wallace. But if I'm on All Madden, like, they need to be picking those off. Right? Like, that literally looks like, oh, everything's on All Madden until it comes time for my AI, my CPU-controlled players, to make a play, and then they're on, like, rookie difficulty. Actually, no. If they're on rookie default difficulty, they would make that interception. It's like, we need to make all Madden harder, so let's make sure that any AI CPU guy, they're going to drop it, because it needs to be harder. Just harder for the sake of being harder. Right on, baby! Right on, baby! All right, can we complete a pass on this drive? Starring the Philadelphia Eagles, can we complete a pass? Fulham, oh, here we go, nice sack. No one got open. Sensational, I mean... Green Bay secondary is not bad, especially from a Madden standpoint, they're not bad. But, I mean, come on, can we get some plays? Fulham makes his first grab of the game. Breaks it a little bit. Dare we try? Like, I almost don't even want to try intercept. Or, that's what we pretty much would call it. I almost don't even want to try an interception. I mean, Hail Mary here. But, we'll see. Maybe just throw it up. Miles Sanders makes a play. Nope. Halftime down 20-0. 2 interceptions and a turnover on downs for this Eagles offense. Not looking good for the win. Not looking good for Fulham to get a depth trade here. We go Rager right at the sticks. Makes the catch. Better get that 1st down. Nice. There we go. Over 100 yards on the game for Miles Sanders. Third and four, have to pass it. Fulham, Goddard, one of those two would be ideal to get open. It is Fulham. Moves the chains. Third and seven on the 28. Every time we've been in field goal range, for the most part, we have, you know, kind of falling apart here a little bit. Let's see. Oh, no, that's not. Oh, that is not a bad pass. Miles Sanders with the grab. Gain of 18. Risky pass, but that's Carson Wentz. He's a gunslinger. Packer fans know what Carson Wentz is all about. You saw it before with Brett Favre. Is that going to go on the eight? Maybe we can get Fulham. Oh, that's not a terrible ball. Travis Fulham, touchdown one of three. The superstar dev trade is still on the menu, boys and girls. Ow, 31, I want to cut him so bad. Like, I honestly might cut Nickell Robey-Coleman. He is... he's so bad. Hey, we get all the... I'm a motivator. I'm like the Mike Tomlin of Madden coaches. I motivate my guys by shitting on them. Come on, don't bite me. I should have went zone defense. Second and 19. I code man to get aggressive. They picked up Fletcher Cox there. Still got a chance to get, you know, holding the field goal. Oh, that had to be it. Man, Fletcher Cox got like stonewalled by the running back. Hey, oh, there you go. Aaron Jones, fan of the channel, gets in for his second rushing touchdown of the game. Yeah, it's pretty much an insurmountable lead at this point, but we can still get Foma dev trade, right? Silver lining, playbook. Oh, that's beautiful. That is beautiful. Now, open field, Foma's not going to make anybody miss. But as long as he can keep getting separation, getting open, we're going to find him. Get Miles Sanders out the backfield. Nice gainer. I'll take it. It's not for the dev trade, but Miles Sanders has earned that touchdown today. Over 100 yards. Easily been our best player. And, you know, we're not going down without a fight. We're swinging. We might lose by decision when all is said and done, but we ain't getting knocked out. Well, that was a terrible play. Second and 10, we get the TFL. Jalen Mills getting in there. 3-yard tackle for loss. Third and 13. Let's go. We'll go Tampa 2. Keep it in front of us. Mark some space. Don't let anyone get behind you. Not Jim Schwartz level of sticks defense. Fletcher Cox dominates on the front. Come on, yes! One-handed sack! Fletcher Cox, baby! Oh, remember that time? The last time I think I had a Madden series with Fletcher Cox, I got 25 sacks in a season. Maybe we'll hit that this year. Might hit it next year. That's a huge stop, though. Forces a punt. All momentum going the way of the Philadelphia Eagles. Oh, that's a nice grab. Third and four. I want to get this up before the end of the quarter here. Fulham is looking like our top guy that we want to go to. He gets wide open. Wentz sends it a little bit high. The adjustment from Travis Fulham as we go into the fourth quarter. He is very much in reach of a superstar dev trade, and we are still very much in reach of a fourth quarter comeback.
So that was a fucking lie.
Got Fulham and Goddard in the slot. Sanders at the backfield. Jalen Rager could be nice and open, which he kind of isn't. That is terrible. I'm sorry. Jason Peters is hurt. That was a god-awful decision. There we go. I was getting ready. Oh, I was going to shit a brick. Fletcher Cox, Derek Barnett getting in there. Should have been a full sack for Fletch. But it's half. Still good, though. Third and 12. Needed that at that point in the field. We'll go zone defense. Cover three. I actually hate the fact that we're rocking and rolling with Darius Slay not on Davante Adams. However, that's a solid stand from this defense. We owe him to a long field goal attempt. There we go! 11.66. Fulham got it. That is awesome. Very happy with that. I don't care. I don't give a fuck. We got the depth trait. 33, you're pretty much just playing for pride. Five. No one was even there. Oh, let's go, Carson. A little bit of a dual threat. Yeah, baby. Garbage time, baby. Let's go. You know what? It's fourth down. I kind of feel bad that we essentially, due to hardware malfunction, shanked that opening field goal for Jake Elliott. So I just want to help him out here a little bit. He's not having a great year. His field goal percentage is way down. He at least deserves to have one completed field goal here today. And it wasn't pretty at all, but it counts. Yeah, that's a tough loss. I mean, is it a tough loss, really? Did we expect, unless, you know, the COVID test would give me superpowers, I probably wasn't going to win this game. I knew right away that there was going to be some bullshit as soon as it was a snow game. And, of course, the game just gave me, like, all white uniforms to make it just even, like, measurably, it's only that much difficult to throw the ball and like, be able to, like, oh, there's my guy. So, whatever. I mean, obviously, Carson Wentz, the turnovers, it just can't happen. 35-17, we fall. I think generally, honestly, even though it looks bad, I think we did an okay job on Aaron Rodgers for the most part, a Darius Slay interception. But, I mean, you could honestly say all three of those picks were on me. We've had some games here with Carson Wentz where I would argue that the picks were cheesy. Yeah, this was all me. This was all... It's happens I don't play Madden for like 4 days. Miles Sanders, though, the run game was on point. 150 yards, a touchdown. He is playing like a top five running back in the NFL right now. Like, right now, it's Derrick Henry, Dalvin Cook, and Miles Sanders might be the third best running back, which is good. Fulham, 11 catches, 166 yards, one touchdown, averaging 15 yards a catch, which was good. 7 for 72 for Dallas Goedert, 59 yards on the backfield for Miles. So over 200 yards from scrimmage again for Miles Sanders. Just a absolute weapon. Jalen Reagor got shut down by Jair Alexander today. It is what it is. We pretty much had to sacrifice Jalen Reagor on Alexander so we can move Fulham into the slot and help him get his dev trade. 11 tackles and an interception for Darius Slay. Probably his best episode so far. We had 2.5 sacks for Fletcher Cox. NRC, Kavon Wallace also got sacked. Half sacks there for Derek Barnett. 2 TFLs, Will Parks. It just, you know, turnovers. If we didn't have those turnovers, if I didn't shank that field goal, who knows what would have happened. But 2 losses in a row, it's not good. Well, the upgrades actually aren't too shabby. All upgrades that I want to see. You got Jordan Mailata. We're just going to continue to feed him into whatever the top tree is. I'm not super worried now. At his age, I just want to maximize the overall potential. We got Fulham up to a 78 overall, and that's before whatever XP we get for him going up a dev trait. We have Carson Wentz. I don't know why he got that, but hey, up to a 79 overall for a quarterback. That is just so many turnovers. But at least I'm being accurate, right? I'm not actually bad at Madden. This wasn't an off game. I'm just trying to be as realistic and accurate as possible. Okay? I'm going to chalk it up to that. But as we can see here, breakout player for Mr. Travis Fulgham. He proved he's one of the best players on this team. He proved it out there today. Keep feeding the ball. Superstar dev trade plus 8. I will make an argument. The fact that when you go from normal dev to a star dev, you get 20,000 XP. And then you only get 8, I believe, for superstar. And only 8 for going to superstar X Factor. Maybe balance that out a little bit. I don't know. That's not a hill that I'm willing to die on. But that is still, at the end of the day, dev trade is nice. There's a silver lining. But it's still a 35-17 loss. We've given up almost 100 points in the last 2 weeks defensively. And if we have any expectations of holding on to the NFC East, got to play a lot better. And you look at the slate. Until probably week 16, and even in week 16, Dallas is a difficult Madden team. The next 2 weeks in particular, it's not going to get any easier. But that will do it for all here today, guys. Let's actually sim a week just so I can see how much points we can spend for Fulham. It's probably only going to be a 1-point upgrade. Maybe 2? No, it's only 1. But we'll make him a nice 79 overall. Take a look at where he's at. What kind of abilities do we have at his disposal? He's now a superstar. That looks awesome. Route Apprentice. Players with this ability have access to 4 additional hot routes regardless of where they line up. Okay, sure, whatever, but I'm feeling good about that. I'm feeling good about him. Next up, I think in terms of deserved dev traits, got to be looking at Miles Sanders. I don't know how many more. I mean, we just failed a dev trade scenario a little bit. Dante Olsen got poached from our practice squad by the 49ers. We did just fail a Miles Sanders one, but I would love to have another opportunity, another crack in the final 4 weeks of the season to get Miles Sanders to go up another dev trade. But we're 5-6-1. It's I mean, look at the playoff picture. We're still in because the NFC leads. We're still the number four seed in the NFC right now. We're slated to play the 49ers. That's a winnable game. Beat the 49ers earlier in the season. I mean, maybe a quick look at the stats now. Carson Wentz, 19-19. Not looking great. Miles Sanders, 900 yards, 12 touchdowns, averaging 100 yards per game. How many games did he miss? Three or four games. So, I mean, he's right on pace there. Fulham, 56 catches, 900 yards, 6 touchdowns. Himself also averaging 100 yards a game. Defensively, Roddy McLeod leads the team with 70 tackles. We got 8.5 sacks, BG, 6.5, Fletcher Cox, 2 picks, Avante Maddox leading the team. Really, the only number that I kind of personally want to, I don't want to say I want more field goals, but I like Jake Elliott a lot. I know he's struggling a little bit this year in real life, and we started with the real stats, and he's not playing well. I'd like to help him out here a little bit, get that field goal percentage as close to 80% as possible. But that's, you know, way, way down the list of priorities. We need to find a way to win. So hopefully we'll be able to win week 14 against the, we probably started this before Breeze's injury. So it's probably the Jameis Winston-led Saints, so we might have a chance. But that'll do for here today, guys. Thank you for watching. Thanks for all the love and continued support here on this Eagles franchise. I have a blast recording it each and every single week. If it's your first time stopping by, don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button. Smash the like button if you enjoyed. Helps the video out in the YouTube algorithm. Gets more eyes on my channel. And all it's free. It's just a little thumbs up. Thank you. But that'll do it for me today, guys. Thank you for watching. Until next time, C4 saying peace out. And hopefully I'm COVID-free. And my son, more importantly.